these are the amateurs working hard here, and like you say, it looks like they're getting some good coaching as well.
Absolutely, you know, got some really good coaches. Danny Benson, as I touched on earlier, really good amateur fighter himself, a lot of amateur fights. Won the ABAs, boxed for England several times. Steve Buckley as well, has been coaching a long, long time. Dean as well, former boxer. He's just going to get his level one shortly. Obviously, I'm here most of the time as well. And there's a couple of the younger boxers actually who've actually got the level one. So there's plenty of coaching going on. And the guy's very lucky, really.
And obviously it's mainly guys, but there is obviously a girl here as well, and that's more of a feature you see in amateur gyms, isn't it? You see more and more girls getting involved.
Absolutely, and you know, Faye's a very good fighter. She's actually in the national semi-final on Sunday in the NABGCs, which is this Sunday, so more women getting into the sport, more girls getting into the sport, and it's good to see.
Right, so we've got Faye McCormick with us. I'm just seeing you there doing your session, and
yeah,
everyone was singing your praises, so you must be doing something, right?
Hopefully.
How long have you been boxing?
About 7 years, since I was 9.
Really? Okay. 9 plus 7, yeah. Right.
Yeah.
I was about to ask you how old you were.
16.
But I can work that out. Right, so, so what actually got you into boxing?
You know what, so my dad did a bit of white collar, and obviously it's not the same as amateur, but it just made me want to go into boxing, try it out.
I've noticed here you're the only girl in here.
Yeah.
Is that a bit intimidating, or do you enjoy it?
No, I enjoy it because I get treated no different to any of the boys. They all treat me like the family, so.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah.
So with training here then, like why is this like the right fit for you?
I can see improvements now, whereas I was at Highland District and it was an amazing club, but here I can see improvements in performance, sparring and training really.
You spar with the lads then?
Yeah.
Yeah? And how'd you find that?
It's alright, it's more technical, so you learn from it really. So.
And tell us about what you've got coming up, because I believe you've got a big day coming up on Sunday.
Yeah, so I'm boxing in the NAGBCs, which is the boys' clubs. And I'm excited for it really, it's my first boxing match for here. So.
And where's that? Good. Whereabouts is that?
It's in Blackburn.
Right, so not too far to go.
No.
Alright, brilliant. And I believe your opponent is a good girl as well, so it's going to be a good fight this one.
Yeah. Just gotta put your all in.
Yeah.
Wish for the best.
Do you want to do this as a career?
Yeah.
Right.
Hope to in the future.
In that case, you better give everyone your Instagram handle so they can follow you.
It's Faye Boxing. That's the name.
I like it. Sweet and simple. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Faye Boxing. Right.
Yeah.
Nice to speak to you, and
you too.
Very best of luck on Sunday.
Thank you.
So the one throwing the initial jab, drawing your opponent on, so I want you to either step out, slip, whatever. Yeah? So one jabbing, one blocking and returning. So the one who threw the original jab has to then defend that. You can either step out ready to counter, step off, whatever you want to slip, okay?
Pull up the foot now. Hey, hey, hey. And the hook.
Hey, 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 hey.
Good. Your head's Come on.
Hey, hey!
Double jab.
Hey, hey!
Come on,
hey, hey!
Back and up.
Hey, hey, hey!
Come on,
two. Hey, hey!
Really, yeah.
Jack, this is Jack Hatton here. You're getting a bit of stick here, aren't you, mate?
I know,
they're
yeah.
Heckling you, aren't they?
All my teammates, yeah.
So, mate, I've just seen you there training and speaking to your old man there. He's very proud of how you're getting along. Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, yeah. I'm really enjoying my boxing at the minute. It's good with the lads as well because we all put the hard work in, but at the same time, like, we have a good laugh as well. So, yeah, I'm really enjoying it at the minute.
Now, I've noticed there, just watching, you've definitely got the bug for the boxing because you can't get your hands off the bag. You love it. So, would that be a fair statement? Are you absolutely loving, like, just being involved in the boxing world?
Yeah, I love the boxing. It's like, for, like, I've had 25 fights now in about 2 years, so there'd be something wrong if I weren't loving it and I was having that many fights, wouldn't I? So, you know, yeah, I'm really enjoying it at the minute.
Tall, southpaw. I believe you get that from your mum's side.
Yeah, not my dad's side.
You don't get it from your dad's side, do you?
No, not at all.
But you've got all the tools there, haven't you? So you're just at the beginning of your career, so to speak. But are you like quite excited about what's to come?
Yeah, yeah. being a tall southpaw, you've got to like. I like a scrap. I get involved a bit too much, but my dad and all that tell me if long arms, tall southpaw, you just got to keep it long and boxing. But sometimes get involved a bit too much. But like, I want to be a good all-round fighter because to be a top fighter, you've got to be good in all the compartments, I feel like.
Yeah, and you've got a good family support, haven't you? Because I know every one of your fights, your family's all there cheering for you, yeah. And everything like that. So that must be good as well.
Yeah, yeah, get really good support off my family and my mates, and it obviously helps when you're fighting, spurring you on and stuff like that.
Do you, I tell why you like it in this gym, because you have a good laugh as well, you work hard, but you have a good laugh, don't you, as well?
Yeah, yeah, really good in the gym at the minute. It's obviously a new gym and that, but I know a lot of the people from this gym and, like, really good sense of humours and that, so can't really get much better.
Now, I know what your old man thinks about your boxing. What does your mum think about your boxing?
She's fine with it, to be fair. When she's fighting, she's never really, like, sat there quiet. She's always just shouting and stuff like that. She's fine with it, to be fair.
Now, you've been doing really, really well, and you're taking good decisions and the bad decisions as well. And
yeah,
I understand that, you know, you guys weren't too happy about the last one, but your mindset's good because you're straight back in the gym and you're training them, aren't you?
Got to have a strong mindset to box. Like, I'll be back out again in, I think it's just under 4 weeks, so no point sulking about my last one. I've just got to kind of put it past me and just get on with it.
Yeah.
Hopefully I get one or two more fights by the end of the year.
Good man, that's a good attitude to have. And this is officially our first interview on record now.
Yep.
Next time we'll do a sit down and, and as it keeps going, we'll maybe end up doing a documentary.
A documentary?
Well, you never know.
I won't be able to speak for that long.
Or we'll come and do a cribs like we've done with your Uncle Ricky. We'll come and do like a cribs when you've got a millionaire house and everything. And
yeah, hopefully one day. Hopefully one day, anyway.
Good man, Jack.
Yep.
All the best of luck in your next
fight. Nice one, Aki. Cheers, mate.
If you think about it, Matt, like the fact that these youngsters are here, rather than doing it God knows what, it's just such a positive influence, isn't it?
Absolutely, and you know, there's some really good fighters here. Some of them are a bit older as well. And I think there's that pathway there. Say they did fancy turning professional one day, you know, they've got the pathway to do it here. So, again, the commitment these guys show. And again, I've always been the coaches for me. The amount of time and effort that the coaches put in, it's amazing, really. I mean, Danny's so dedicated, as are the other guy. Like yesterday, you know, Danny's got a small family himself, he's got his own children. He was here yesterday as well with a lad sparring, you know what I mean? And I just think these coaches that give the time, I mean, they're amazing, I really do.
Right, we have some of the amateur trainers here who I've just been speaking to Matt about. So let's go down the line. Do you want to introduce yourselves?
Hey, my name's Steve Buckley.
Hi, I'm Dean Fieldhouse. I'm Dan Benson.
Right, there we go, lads. So I've just been watching you guys all working there, and Steve, it was like some great fundamentals there you were teaching the kids, and they were responding well by the look of it.
Yeah, we tried to do technical a couple of times a week, get them working on the defences and footwork.
And Dean, you're doing your level one, is that right at the minute?
Yeah, I'll be doing that next year, I think, as soon as I get booked in. So I've only been here about 2 months or so, but yeah, no, I enjoyed it.
Also, he's a newbie.
I'm a newbie, mate, yeah.
Have you given him an initiation yet?
No, not yet. Still thinking of him. Let him off because he's a blue, but he's a scouser, so he's going to get a bad one.
I saw the post Matt put out. Obviously, you joined the gym now, yeah. And you I've seen you there working on the pads and everything. Former fighter, as I think you're a former fighter as well.
Yeah, many years ago.
So, I mean, what is it that made you want to get into doing this now?
So, I was coaching at another gym previously for about 18 months or so, and something I've always had a passion for, really, my boxing. Just thought, give a bit back now.
Yeah, great. And what's like, would you say, we've been talking about, like, doing a video about, like, the amateur world and amateur trainers and stuff who give a lot of their free time up. What motivates you to do it?
Well, I boxed as a kid when I was like 11. I stopped when I was about 13, but I credit my coach back then teaching me a lot of respect and discipline. And I think it's as much about that as teaching them to box.
Yeah.
Teaching them how to respect the coaches and that with discipline in and out the ring.
Yeah. And what makes here a good environment for the kids?
I think everyone's sort of pulling together in the right direction. There's a good team spirit. I think everyone wants each other to do well. They push each other on well. They're a good, to be fair, they're a really good bunch of lads. So I think that's what makes it probably quite special here, to be fair.
Is anyone we need to be keeping an eye out on?
Yeah, most of them, to be honest. We've got, obviously, Jack Atten, who's had 24 now. He's doing really well, 121. Jack Swallow, he's the big Asian lad. He's good. Yeah, got big ears, but he's a good talent, right? There's some good lads.
And girls.
And girls, yeah. Faye's brilliant, yeah.
Yeah, so I've just been hearing about her as well. She's got something coming up this weekend. Do you want to tell us about what she's got coming?
Yeah, so she boxed in the boys club semi-finals. She's got a really good girl. She's a two-time national champion for Middlesbrough. But it's a step up, I think, we're ready for. She's really talented, Faye, and I think good time for her now.
And what, you know, we're going to see parents who might watch this. What would you say to parents about if they're a bit nervous about getting the kids involved in boxing?
I think there's a lot of possibly negative press about boxing. I think they used to have it in schools, didn't they? But then the government banned it. Like I say, the kids aren't going to get hurt when they're sparring or competing. It's very safe for them, and it teaches them a lot. So I think it's a massive positive if you can get your kids into boxing.
Tell us about when are the classes on here then? Like what times?
So
this is Stockport and Bredby, by the way, guys. Pair mill.
So the seniors or the carded boxers are sort of 8 till 8:30, 9. And then I think the junior ones are starting in January, so from like 10 to 16, anyone who wants to get into boxing, they'll do sort of 7 to 8 Monday to Friday, and then when they're ready, they'll get promoted up into the sort of more senior classes.
Great. What's next up for the gym then? What's the next event?
So we've got a really busy month coming up actually. We've got Jack Swallow boxing in Liverpool on Friday. We've got Faye, like we were saying, in the boys' clubs on Sunday. And then pretty much everybody in the gym in the next 3 or 4 weeks. And we've got the Roy Richardson dinner show, that's the 7th of December. We've got, I think, is it 6 lads we've got on there? So yeah, it's a really busy show.
What a legend Roy was.
Yeah, top man Roy, yeah.
It's been great chatting to you guys, and I got some good footage of you whilst you weren't looking. So I'm looking forward to you seeing that back. But yeah, cheers for speaking to us.
Cheers,
thank you.
Cheers.
I don't know how much you want to go into this next question, but it's completely up to you, but I did hear speaking to a couple of people that Jack had a bit of a, what could be considered a dodgy decision the other day when he fought in the amateur game. And I did see a post from yourself, and it was obviously a bit of a sensitive topic, let's say. What do you make of it? Because you often do hear about in the amateur game that's a quibble from quite a lot of people. So what did you make of the whole thing, and how much you want to say on that, basically?
Mate, it was very, very poor. It really was. We've all been beat. You have to be gracious in defeat and have respect for your opponent. The last fight which Jack lost was a good while ago now. He's doing very well. You know, he lost clearly, he lost comfortably. He lost to the better kid on the night. But last weekend, it was a stinker. It was a bad, bad decision. It really was. I thought he'd won every round. The kid had a point taken off in the second round for holding. After the fight, they announced, you know, there was ages in the ring. They announced it a split decision win for the other kid. So disappointed. Everyone's coming up to me saying he'd been robbed. Then, to make things worse, one of the officials actually come over and said he thought that they'd added the scorecards up wrong. So Danny went over, his coach. They hadn't added the scorecards up wrong. They'd give it the other kid by a split decision. The referee, who's been officiating, a top official, an international referee, he went over, he wanted to see the scorecards as well, so that tells you all you need to know, really. That's probably best for me to leave it at that, but it was a poor decision. It really was, but you've got to dust yourself down and carry on. He was back in the gym the next night, and you see things like that, and it does make you a little bit disillusioned and disappointed, especially when the kids work so hard. But you come in here, you get working again, see the kids enjoying it, and you soon get that enthusiasm back.
Yeah, the reason I mention it is because you do hear this a lot now. The amateur coaches are the salt of the earth, who basically keep the sport going, and they give up so much free time for free, unpaid, and they travel a lot, and etc. So to put all that work in, and then sometimes to have a decision which could be conceived quite blatantly wrong. How does that sort of make the fighters feel? Because I mean, I was Jack after that, and do you think that's something that really needs to be addressed in the game, which is a beautiful thing, the amateur game, but that's one side of it which could be addressed.
You know, there is some poor officials, and then sometimes you think, is there more to it? I know what my opinions are on it. It's, you know, it is very frustrating, you know, because these kids put the work in, you know, and we all get into amateur boxing, and the reason I'm getting involved, because I enjoy my coaching, I want to help these kids out, and I do think that's been lost, you know, some way. Jack was really disappointed, you know, didn't want to get up, didn't want to get out of bed the next day, didn't want to go to school, he felt cheated, he felt hard done to, but you've just got to dust yourself down and crack on. But for the fighters and the coaches, it's heartbreaking. Like I say, Danny puts a lot of his time and effort into these guys, you know, unpaid. None of the guys are paid, they're all volunteers, and it's disappointing, really is.
Yeah, fair enough. But on the other side as well, though, is that amateur game does a lot for kids, and it's built some world superstars as well, the amateur game, hasn't it?
Absolutely, it's where we all learn, isn't it? And, you know, like you say, Jack's really enjoying his amateur boxing, and they're in there, they're learning. You know, some aspire to turn professional one day, some don't. They just love the amateur game, and on the whole, it's a great thing.
Just moving on to talk about Campbell. I saw the title of the video that was posted after the fight, controversial disqualification or something like that. It was an odd ending, wasn't it, to the fight? And I feel like sometimes fighters who have something like that, a result like that, they get a bit of stick afterwards for something that's not necessarily their fault. But what's been the fallout from that fight?
Yeah, I thought it was, obviously it wasn't a good fight, it wasn't a good performance. Campbell probably could and should have boxed a little bit better. But again, I've got to be honest, I've got to tell it the way I see it. I thought it was a terrible choice of opponent. It wasn't the opponent I wanted. I expressed that to the matchmaker and to everyone. I said he was holding a lot in his last fight. I didn't want it to ruin the fight. But I did go with it in the end, because being honest, I didn't think he was capable of beating Campbell. But I thought from the lad, you know, a big opportunity, big platform, big night, big crowd, and I thought he was terrible. I thought the only thing, I thought the referee could have possibly disqualified him a little bit earlier. He was just holding and holding and holding. So negative. You know, Campbell's caught for a bit of criticism. Probably, like I've just said, could and should have probably done a little bit better, but very, very difficult when someone's that negative and holding it. I thought some of the criticism he's received has been a bit unjust, really.
That's the thing I was getting at, because sometimes you see decisions that are out of the fighter's hand, and then they bear the brunt of it. Mm. What's that? That must be frustrating.
Very frustrating. You know, he'd had a good training camp. Campbell's coming on a treat, and on the whole, the year's been great. He's got consistently, I'd say he's probably one of the most improved fighters in the country, actually.
He's been very active, actually, hasn't he?
Very active, yeah. Very active, and he's improving fight by fight. It was just such a shame that it was such a mess last time, and that was down to a pretty dire performance from the opponent, just holding and holding. I don't think his phone will be ringing for a while.
I want to touch on something I saw you post this, correct me if I'm wrong, but it was about a potential matchup between Campbell and Jimmy Joe Flint. Was that you who posted that? Or?
Yeah, I saw Steffi Bowles. I know Steffi well, I like Steffi. He was talking about it, and I just said straight away, you know, it'd be a good fight now.
Yeah.
I think that's the right kind of move for Campbell. I mean, it's a great fight for both.
It'd be a good fight to watch that. I mean, Jimmy Joe's a great lad himself
yeah,
as well.
I
remember interviewing him years ago, top lad. Both got that sort of style where they're going to meet in the middle, sort of thing. What is that? Were you thinking central area English or having something on the line like that?
Yeah, well, Jimmy's the central area champion, isn't
right,
he? Maybe
okay,
they could
yeah,
maybe could double it up as an English title eliminator or something like that. But I just think for both guys, for Campbell, I think he's ready to make that move now. And what a great opportunity for Jimmy Joe on the big stage, so why not?
How far have those sort of conversations gone down the line, and what platform would it be on and all the rest of that sort of stuff?
Yeah, not too sure, to be honest. I mean, I believe they are talking. I don't manage Campbell, I only train him. Ricky manages him, but I know Matchroom are in discussions with Steffi Bull, so hopefully we'll hear something soon regarding that fight. But if I had my choice, that's the way I'd go next.
Do you think that's the fight that will, because obviously that will be seen as a step up, it will be seen, it's a 50-50 to be honest on paper, isn't it? So do you think that's the time is just right for to sort of, not deep waters, but you know, to put him in that test and see how he gets on?
Yeah, 14 fights down the line now, Campbell. So again, he's still only 22 years of age. So you know, we're not chucking him in at the deep end, so to speak. I think it's a step up in opponent against someone who's coming to fight. It'll be Jimmy Joe's biggest test too, boxing Campbell. And I just think it just makes sense for both. So hopefully we can get that done.